Hello everyone, I am going to explain you about Siemens S7200 PLC. So let us start. This PLC has S7200 and CPUs 2 to 4, DC, DC, DC. So you see here Q0 to Q7, these are all outputs, and here bottom, these are all inputs. So this PLC basically has 14 inputs and 10 outputs. So here you see wiring connection of Siemens PLC. So all are DC inputs, 24 volt DC operatable. So this is how we connect it. X0, X1, X2, X3, all are inputs, and outputs are shown by Q0, Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4, Q5. So these are all outputs. So here we see how we can do addressing Siemens PLC for inputs, outputs, analog input, analog output. So input are I0, I1, digital output are denoted by Q0, and analog input addressing is denoted by AIW, and similarly analog output AQ. So here you see a classification of timer. Timer basically are used to provide delay to the output device. So basically we have three categories of timer: TONR, this is tentative on delay timer, and second one is T on, third one is T off timer. So here you see what symbols we used in programming: NONC, output coil, these are all symbols that we used in programming. So next is what software is required to program S7200 PLC, Siemens PLC, and cable. So software is StepSign MicroWin, cable is PPI point to point interface. S7200 simulator, we will use simulator in this case to test our ladder program. So let us start programming. So we have opened StepSign MicroWin software. So first we will connect input, and with the input we will connect output. So as you know, we use input addressing I0.0, okay, and for output we will use Q0.0. So Q0.0 will go up to Q0.7, and if you want to connect another input like 9th input, then the addressing will be Q1.0. So this is simple program that the output will be operated by one single input. So now you will save the program. As we are testing on simulator, so we will export this program. Now we have opened this simulator SM200. Okay, so let us check simulation of program. So you see in go to program, wait, just hold on. Okay, I think it's not working right now, so we are closing. So if something happened wrong, you can close this software with the task manager if doesn't normally closed. So opening again the simulation software SM200, you can download from Google, it is free available. To just check your program whether it is working fine or not, so you just click on ignore if this pop-up come up. Again not working, something happened wrong, so sorry for this guys. Okay, so password is in the software folder. You can check what the password is in the folder. So here we have just 1, 2, 3, 4. So you see S7200 6596 password, but I have changed the software password, so that's why. So you will load the program that you have exported previously. Okay, so that program was program.awl file that we had exported. Okay, so this program now opened. So click on run, run the CPU. You see it is in now green running status. Now this is I0.0 input. So when you switch on the input, the output also goes on. So this is how you test the program. Now move on to some extra level program. So as we told you about timer, so here in instruction block you will see the last timer block. Okay, T on, T on, R, T off. So we are using T on timer, so addressing T32. So preset time we have given 10,000, so this is for 10 second delay. Okay, so this is output of timer T32, and we connect it output device Q0.0. so again you export this program. So P2 is file name that we had exported. Now again do the same process, stop the CPU and go to program, load again program that we have exported. So now program is open. So what will happen, once we switch on the I0.0 input, then after 10 second delay the Q0.0 output will goes on. So we have switch on I0.0. So you see timer is running. So after 10 second delay you will see the output Q0.0 will go high.